Hi, I'm Trent Anthony with Monument Real Estate. After working several years in the real estate industry, I decided to serve the wonderful people of Southeast Louisiana by opening a locally owned company where each client is treated with a tremendous amount of respect and importance. Serving the North Shore, Baton Rouge, and New Orleans regions, Monument has the ability to broker all types of real estate transactions.
Kim Coates, one of our new lawmakers, is leaving here, being Hammond and the Morning Rotary, and heading right to Baton Rouge for a hearing on carbon capture that is in part the Lake Maurepas project. But there's little doubt that this process is just going to grind on, correct?
Yeah. Yesterday in committee, you know, it was all about the jobs and the money and stuff. But, you know, one of the things that I was pointing out, that, and it was brought up by another representative, that, you know, the federal government is dishing out all this money. And what about the deficit and the federal budget? You know, the feds back from like 09 to... I can't remember the exact date, but it was like for years that put out these carbon credits and stuff, and they spent $1 billion on 12 projects and only two made it. So then they increased the decreased the requirements to be able to get those carbon credits. So then they put out another $5 billion, then they put out another $8 billion. So they're putting out all this money only to reduce the emissions by 3%. You know, it's just, it's a money grab. And it's very sad that we're having to take all of the risk. There's, I believe, through Congress, one of the sites that I was reading, there's 121 projects proposed. 56 is coming to Louisiana. It's already applied. So this is gonna be all over the state. And, you know, I'm just worried it is just fast-tracking so far, so fast that, you know, the people really don't have a grasp of what's been going on.
We've heard, for example, on the project that most are concerned about, the Lake Maurepas project, that it's maybe a six-year build-out. And you have to wonder, going forward 6 years, we might get another Republican president. And who knows what will happen to the money, correct?
Well, so, but President Trump is one of the ones that actually increased the credits, too. So I don't think that that's going to happen. You know, now one thing I did learn in committee yesterday that also, again, concerns me about Lake Maurepas again, is that about every 3 years they have to do seismic testing. So again, we're going to have the dynamite and all of that under the lake every 3 years. So, you know, it's just when can we protect what is so sacred?
Is there a plan, maybe a plan B, to do anything else for Lake Maurepas?
So I'm bringing the bill again that Representative Nikki Muscarella tried to pass last year, to where no structures can be built above the surface of the water in Maurepas or Pontchartrain or windmills. So I'm hearing, you know, windmills are coming to the lake. And that's just not a place to put this. Like, I know we're working on putting it out in a Gulf and stuff, but putting it in here in a recreational place, we're just getting all of our, you know, pelicans and birds and things back. I just don't think that that's the place for it.
Well, on the other hand, if you put the structures under the water, wouldn't they be a hazard to boating?
So if it's they're talking about doing directional drilling under the surface. So no, I don't think that will, but I'm really worried about the things above the water and above the surface. You know, tragically, a couple months ago, we had a wreck on the Manchac Bridge with 108 vehicle car pileup because of the fog. I've been out in that lake when it's foggy and you have no sense of direction. And they're going to build, according to my questions yesterday to the secretary and the commissioner, they're going to put the injection wells, and there's about 7 wells around each injection well. And they said mostly those monitoring wells are going to be on the outside of this cap that's under the lake. That's going to litter the entire lake with all of these structures. So we know for sure there's going to be 2 injection wells, so then there's 7 for each well. So It's just very frustrating, but, you know, we're getting very good feedback on Maurepaw. People are really starting to listen. And, you know, I think we can move forward. It's just, how is it going to turn out? I'm not sure.
What else are you working on?
Well, here in Hammond, you know, we have our beloved CASA that, you know, advocates for children and stuff. And I'm bringing a bill to protect their testimonies on the civil side. So in criminal cases, those children's testimonies are protected and only a judge can see those. But on the civil side, they are not protected. So I'm passing the bill to protect those children across the board.
Hi, I'm Trent Anthony with Monument Real Estate. After working several years in the real estate industry, I decided to serve the wonderful people of Southeast Louisiana by opening a locally owned company where each client is treated with a tremendous amount of respect and importance. Serving the North Shore, Baton Rouge, and New Orleans regions, Monument has the ability to broker all types of real estate transactions. Your real estate needs are very important to us, so let me or one of our team members help you make your mark with Monument Real Estate.